Hey guys. So here's a tip. Don't work out. I did yesterday. I was like, oh, gotta look hot for the show. Can't even sit down and take a shit! Yeah! That's how it goes, right? So I love magazines. It's where I got a lot of my content when I was growing up, right? But it was a progression. So it went like J14, 17 magazine, and then Cosmo. And it's kind of like, you know, when you start off with pads, and then you go tampons to pants at night to just fucking with tampons. Fucking with them all the time. But essentially, that's the progression, right? And so for fashion, J14 was like, what to wear on your first day of sophomore year? Which, like, kind of pissed me off, because it's grade 10, okay? It's grade 10. It's Canadian girls. Okay? And you have the Australian chicks in the back, like, actually, it's year 10, okay? Right? Or just go fuck yourself, you koala fucking. And then, so yeah, and then for 17 magazine, it's like, well, how to make your outfit work for day and night. And Cosmo's like, how many dicks will you sell you a crap? Yeah, that's how it goes. And then J14 is the same kind of thing for love, right? It's like, Nick Jonas was seen eating some ice cream. What's your favorite flavor of ice cream? And then 17 magazine's like, what's your ideal date with Nick Jonas? And then Cosmo's just like, how to suck you through this bottle! But yeah, Cosmo's ridiculous. But like, all women, including myself, are like drawn to it. Like a moth to a flame, right? Like, how hot are sex now? Yes. How to be a Picasso with a peen? Yes. How to suck a butthole in 15 different ways? Yes. Yes. But, and some of the articles are literally ridiculous. Like, one of them was like, what is a woman's ideal dick size? It's like, if you're this age and this weight or whatever, your ideal dick is like X height plus X width divided by the circumference. Oh my god! Oh! Okay, all right. Too many numbers, right? Who knew math could be so scandalous? If Melissa needs a dick that's 7.5 inches in length, and Jonathan has a radius of 2.5, and Frederick has a diameter of 3.7, he'll satisfy her needs. There's some other fucking weird articles, too. One of them was like, incorporate food into your foreplay. Put a donut on his dick and... Like, who the fuck comes out of that shit? Right? Like, okay, guys, you know, new issue, we need some new content. What do we got? Oh, sir, how about we incorporate a Lady and the Tramp type thing to our article? Wait. Lady, Tramp, noodles. That's it! We'll put food on the genitals! But it's gotta be dessert, because let's get real, no one's gonna eat general towel off of someone's butthole. But third, we just found that last month that dessert will kill their sex drive. Then we'll put it on a peen. And so, if my man, you know, was ever considering doing the donut on the dick thing, it would only go down in a few number of ways. Number one, if it's not Krispy Kreme, I'm not down. I don't fuck with shit. It's not Krispy Kreme. Some guy comes in bringing me a piece of no-name fried dough. Psh, bitch, do I look like a peasant to you? Was there something in my apparel that would indicate otherwise? A pay for these ribs, ho? That was exclusive. So anyways, if it is Krispy Kreme, I can smell that shit as soon as I walk through the door. Okay, I can sense that the donut has been there. I smell it. Up the stairs I go, my vision red with desire for the fried goodness. It's behind the bedroom door. I bust it down! Ambushing the unexpected, the line between donut and peen is blurred! And really, the whole thing would just be a... It would just be a mess, right? I'd also like to apologize saying butthole a total of 15 times in this past 5 minutes. I'm gonna go work out those issues right over there.